I found this Sonicake Black Hammer multi-effects sitting on a shelf. Don't know why I didn't demo it, but I'm demoing it now. These run at about, anywhere between $80 and $100 on the internet, places like Amazon, those sorts of, you know, big online warehouse people sell them. It's there's no cabinet emulation on this one. I know that the Rockstage, I think, had cabinet emulation. I can't remember. And the Twiggy. This guy is a multi-effects pedal specifically aimed at metalheads. You've got a boost. It sounds like it'll boost up to about 20 dB into the front of this high-gain distortion. And then after the distortion, you've got a chorus and you've got a delay. This is the Charvel Charvel San Dimas HH and the HH humbuckers. And it's a Jeff Beck in the back, a Seymour Duncan Jeff Beck in the back, and a 59 in the front. To demonstrate this adequately, I've got a very clean Shiva in the axe effects happening here, so it's pretty homogenized. So we'll begin with the high gain distortion, because that's obviously going to be the most important element on this guy. You've got a noise reduction circuit here, which, because I'm using humbuckers, I don't really need to use much volume, bass, middle, treble, gain. So if I wind the gain all the way down, that's about as low gain as you're going to get it with these pickups. Pull out a Tele in a minute and we'll have a look at that too. If we go to, say, 10 o'clock. Classic rock. And of course we can adjust, you know, the tone of that with the bass, middle and treble. The middle has the most influence. That's a pretty good distortion, I reckon. If we up the treble, likewise with the bass, we can get some real thump if we gun it. I personally wouldn't. I'd probably back it off to tighten it up and not get in the way of the bass and drums. If we go to, say, 2 o'clock, starting to get pretty saturated in terms of its overdrive and distortion. There's that middle control again, really quite effective. Gain all the way. So what I'd probably do is back the gain down to, you know, 10 or 11 o'clock. And then use the boost in front of it to give me that little bit of extra gain for solo. Then I could inject a bit of ambiance with the delay. You've got a level control and a repeats control and a time control. Something like that. Yeah, there's a chorus. Now, I've got to say, this is probably the weakest part of this pedal. It's not a great chorus. To my ears, anyway. It's got a level control, a depth control, so it can get very warbly. ¶¶ we can get something that's, you know, acceptable just by backing all of these controls down a little bit. You can see that boost is effective on its own. So there you go. Let's see how it fares with something as gentle as an old school Tele. This is a 70th anniversary Broadcaster. This year's actually, and clean, it sounds like this. Not much distortion happening there. So let's see if we can turn this high gain into something that's suitable in terms of overdrive for a Tele. Nothing wrong with that. That's pretty gainy though. So we'll start by backing this gain right back. Just to the point after, you know, if we back it away, all the way back, it sounds crap. But about there. Yep, nothing wrong with that. Turn that noise reduction off. Then we can use the boost to boost it. So there it is, a budget multi-effects pedal boost distortion chorus and delay. The delay is nice, nice kind of analog sounding delay for about $100 or less, available from most of the big onliners. Sonicake Black Hammer. Bye.